You're now listening to Dating and Relationships Real Talk with Dr. Shell on HotAtlantaMix106.com. The beat of Atlanta. You can visit us on the web at ScreenWorksEntertainment.com.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Dating and Relationships Real Talk with Dr. Shell. I am so excited. You know, this is episode number 4. We are on every Saturday and Sunday from 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to 7:30 p.m. You can catch me on Hot Atlanta 106 FM, the beat of Atlanta, at www.hotatlantamix106.com. And don't forget to follow me on social media at on Facebook. You can follow me at Michelle A. Roberts, I-N-C, and that's M-I-C-H-E-L-L-E-A-R-O-B-E-R-T-S-I-N-C. I'm on Twitter. You can tweet me at M-A Roberts, I-N-C. And I'm on Periscope at M.A. Roberts, I-N-C. I'm on Instagram at M.A. Roberts, I-N-C. So look for me on social media. Also, go to my website, www.michellearoberts.com, and go up to the contact section at the top. I want you to send me your topics, your questions, and if you'd like to be a guest on the show. And also, sponsors, we're looking for you. I need you. I want you. Guess what? We have a listening audience of over 300,000 people monthly. I did say 300,000 people monthly. We are listening to in the United States and over 86 other countries, okay? So we definitely can get the word out about you. So contact me at MichelleARoberts.com at the contact section at the top, and I can also see some sponsorship packages out, okay? So, let's kind of get into the meat of the show. Well, what's going on? In case you don't know about me, I'm again Michelle A. Roberts. You can call me Dr. Shell, and I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I'm a professional speaker and public author. I specialize in training and encouraging women that they are overcomers, and they can come back from any challenge. I also help my girls to win at the dating game through strategy, life lessons. I arm you, I equip you with the knowledge that you need of the game and the pearls of winning at the dating game. This will give you the ability to have an effective and loving relationship. Again, if you want a one-on-one session with me or some group coaching, you can go to my site at www.michellearoberts.com. Go on to the More tab and look for my coaching services, because I want to help you guys to be as successful as possible. If you don't have the time for coaching, then go get the book, Dr. Shell's 100 Tips on Dating. You can get that at bit.ly/Dr. Shell 100 Tips. That's bit.ly/DRSHELLS100TIPS, okay? So, guess what? Let's get into the show a little bit. Today's show, we're going to touch on some tips on dating after 50. So a lot of times people don't want to talk about dating after 50. A lot of times they concentrate on the young and that's why, you know, you my 25 and over, 25 to 35, I ain't mad at you. I got some tips for you guys, too. But a lot of times, the older dating, I would say, you know, from 45 up, people forget about it. Sometimes they are single because of a death, okay? Sometimes it's because of divorce. Maybe they just have never gotten married or wanted to get married, but they like to date, okay? So these are some tips on dating after 50, and I'm going to give you some conversation starters for you, for those of you that may not be like me. I don't mind talking, okay? I don't mind asking questions, but sometimes if you're a little bit more of an introvert, and especially when you first meet someone, you may be a little nervous or what have you. So we're going to talk about some conversation starters. And also the question of the day. Guess what? I finally got a question from a guy. I'm so pumped about it. It says, Dear Dr. Shell, did I say something wrong? I was just being truthful. Now, I'm not going to read the letter yet, you guys, but you know, men, sometimes y'all are kind of direct, and sometimes when we're a little sensitive, so I don't know if that's the case of this letter. Well, I do know, but I'm not going to tell you guys yet. I'm going to let you guys to determine that. But, you know, maybe, you know, you can be a little less direct and a little bit gentle. And I think sometimes it's not the package that you bring, it's the way you carry that package, you know. Just like when we're talking women to guys, you know, I'm not going to say you can, because you can do whatever you want, but a lot of neck rolling and finger popping and, you know, smacking of the lips is really not going to go over well when you're trying to make a good point. And also, I believe in sharing in love. You know what I'm saying? If you're upset about a situation, if you can't talk about it right now, table it. There's nothing wrong with saying, let's talk. Right now, we're a little heated. Even if he's not heated, I'm a little heated, okay? Let's talk about this later. We can be a little bit more calm, okay? So, sometimes it's not the package that you bring. It's the way you bring the package. And if you can bring the package in with empathy, with love, with care, with sensitivity, a lot of times, even if what you're saying is a little harsh, it can be digested. And I can eat it better, you know? I may not like a hamburger, but if I have a little water, you know, to help it go down a little bit, maybe, you know, you don't gain some dessert, you know, a little sweetness to go down, you know, I can digest it better. And I know that it's not an attack. A lot of times, that's men and women, a lot of times when you're saying something, the person feels attacked. You. That's not a good thing to say when you're trying to get your point across. You can say, this is how I feel when you say so-and-so to me, or this is the way I have perceived it. That might be a little bit better. You know, I'm going to talk about how to dissolve some arguments or some argument strategy, but not today, okay? So, let's continue on. Let's talk about the conversation starters that can be good for you. Let's see. One of the ones that, you know, some cool things or some easy things to talk about would be like this. What are your hobbies? This is one of my favorites. What are your favorite foods? You know, I really like this. The reason I like this one, you guys, because I really don't like a whole lot of different stuff. And so I am, in my mind, open to trying different things to a certain extent. But certain things I just do not like. So when people ask me what my favorite food, I really like to give something to the guys. A lot of times they're trying to get to know you. They might want to cook something. I might want to take you something. For me, I'm allergic to seafood. And a lot of people love fish and crabs and all this kind of stuff. Well, I really have to take some Benadryl, and I really don't need to eat it at all. But every now and then, I do get a hankering. I did say a hankering. I'm from the South. For some crab legs, with some butter and garlic, you know. But I really have to Benadryl up for a few days, you know, really get into my system and stuff. And I really don't need to do it at all, you know, because I've had some bad reactions. So, you know, I think, what are your favorite foods? What makes you laugh? Oh, my goodness, you know, let us tell you. You know, so that's like an easy way of trying to get to know them, you know. What is your guilty pleasure, okay? What is your my guilty pleasure is going to, and this is a girly thing. Y'all let me know, girls out there in the audience, if y'all can relate. You know, I love getting that new hairdo, okay? I love, if I can get my new hairdo, my lashes done, my eyebrows done, my feet and my nails, OMG, I am so cute, okay? And that is like I will be giddy all day long. Smiling, you know, how you doing? Awesome, fabulous, and amazing. You know, that is my guilty pleasure. I love that self-pampering. I love the new hairdo. You know, I don't know why though. See, I don't realize that sometimes you can't, you know, girl, you know, how you can't get it like they did it, but, you know, that's why you gotta have to go and take that picture that first day. Because that next day, after you don't flap over it overnight and all this kind of stuff, you never quite get it the way that the, your beautician can get it, you know. But anyway. Another one would be, do you prefer books or movies? You know, what's your favorite movie? One of my favorites is The Color Purple. Believe it or not, I love The Color Purple. I can say it over and over, you know, all the lines. I just love The Color Purple, okay? Oh, this is good. What food do you like to eat, but you can't help yourself? I just told you mine, so that's a good one. What are some talents that you have? I think that's a great one. I am a multi-talented person. I am an author, I'm a speaker, but I can also sing a little bit. So I actually love karaoke. And you know what my favorite song is? It's My Gladys Knight. If I was your woman and you were my man, you'd have no other woman. You'd be weak as a man. So, that's a good one, okay? What was the last movie you watched at the theater? Not on TV, because a lot of times we don't even take time to go to the movies. I know I haven't been in a minute, and I actually love movies, okay? What about this one? Who is your favorite entertainer? It could be an actor, a comedian, you know, actress, a musician. That's a good one. Do you like watching any sports? For Michelle A. Roberts, that would be a no. But you got a lot of people out there that are sports buffs, you know what I'm saying? Do you play any sports? For me, that would be a no. But if you talk to a guy, he might want to tell you that he plays football. And, you know, sometimes you assume, like, you see a real tall guy, and you say, did you play basketball? A lot of times, sometimes they don't even, you know, play sports like that. And remember, you guys, let me do some housekeeping things. Make sure you follow me on social media at Facebook, Michelle A. Roberts, INC. Also, Twitter, tweet me at M.A. Roberts, INC. I'm on IG, Instagram at M.A. Roberts, INC. Periscope at M.A. Roberts, INC. My website is MichelleARoberts.com. Like I said, you can go to the top of the heading. Under contact, you can send me any topics you'd like to discuss, your Dr. Shell questions, if you'd like to be a guest on the show, if you'd like to run an ad with the show, if you'd like to be a sponsor. I'm looking for, I'm going to get me a great sponsor. I'm just calling in because I believe in speaking into the atmosphere, okay? So I know that my sponsorships are coming in like a blizzard. I believe it. All right, we're going to, I'm going to read this, letter, and then we're going to get back to some conversation starters. No. You know what? Before that, let's do some more tips. I don't think I need some tips on dating after 50. How about that? Let's get into that. And then we'll read the letter. Okay? Dating after 50. What are some places that you can meet somebody? You know, you want to be positive. And keep an open mind, okay? And just jump into it. Be on and ready to be successful. Now, don't say boo when you hear this one. But how about this one? Join a senior citizen center. I know you're saying, girl, bye. No, listen. These folks, they party, they travel, and they always have activity. There are a lot of eligible men and women, and they are not all sick and out of shape. I know you know some people. I'm one of them who over 50, a little over 50, and they look good for the age. And they ain't sick. They like to travel. They like to do stuff. So what about a place that you can find them at? You know, with activities, traveling, swimming, and eligible. A lot of times it may be because of death. You know, they might be a widow, or widower, or, you know, maybe it's been divorced, or you just never know. But, hey. The place. Keep an open mind. How about this one? One of the things I like old school R&B. And guess what? Who knew? They have clubs for the 40 and up. How about that? They play that type of music. They have line dancing classes. And there's more eligible men and women. And even karaoke. I already told you, I love karaoke. So, whoo, you know, you might be in the audience singing your song. And it may be good or bad, but somebody may be saying, ooh, she cute. Isn't he handsome? All right. Got that very white voice. You just never know. Another one. Go to meetup.com. And meetup.com is not paying me, but this is just a great place, a great resource. You can put in your interest. They have a lot of great options. If you like to travel, they have travel clubs, dance clubs, high adventure, sewing, knitting, bowling. And the list just goes on and on. So you know, everybody doesn't like the same thing. That's what makes us all different and special, because it's different strokes for different folks. So, you know, check that out. How about this one? Don't be afraid of it. And really, it's the way that, you know, it's like you're listening to me online. They have online dating now. Now, I know this may be a little scary, okay, especially when you're a little bit over 50 and over, and you really have not been on the World Wide Web a whole lot. You know, maybe all you got is a Facebook page. But you can get somebody younger to help you if you need. But it's really, most of them are free to sign up. And I would suggest that you do it free at first. Some of them do have a cost. But start off free. Post you a nice picture, a clear one, a recent one, a true one. Don't post your picture from 25 years ago, okay? Don't do it. Post a real picture, post a headshot, post a full body picture as well. And the reason that I say that is because some people look skinny in the face, okay? Then they post a look and they expand their big. Or they can be very little, okay? And therefore, if a person knows that they really are not attracted to a heavy set man or a heavy set woman or a very thin woman or very thin girl, or if they like a more athletic build, they will see those things through your pictures. But first of all, when you do your online dating profile, you only have a few words to say, and basically, it's really they're looking at your picture, and then, especially for men, because they're normally attracted, you know, by looks and shapes and all that kind of thing. And heck, right? Me too. You know, if I see a person that's not attracted to me, I'm gonna keep on scrolling, you know what I'm saying? But whatever that thing is that's attractive. So post a nice picture, start with the free one, and just see where it leads, you know? Also, I'm going to put this out there because I don't want to be safe when you're doing online dating. Be safe. If you decide to take it from online to offline and you decide that you're going to meet someone at a location, make sure that location is safe, okay? Do it during the day, like at a great restaurant or coffee shop. I love Starbucks. You know, I told you guys that before. Especially if you just, you know, want to do a little lunch break, but you might not want to, you know, do a dinner thing. You just want to kind of see if you're vibing, you know? So enough about that one. That's a good one. Online dating. Don't be afraid of it. If you have any more questions about that, we can talk about that on another show. How about this one? How about volunteering at places? That's a great place to meet people. Here in Atlanta, we got a place called Habitat for Humanity, I think it is. And they build homes for needy people, you know, not so wealthy people or, you know, low income or single moms or elderly. Or sometimes they go fix up on homes to help in those cases. If you like doing stuff like that, working with your hands, hey, do that. Feed the hungry places. They have a lot of food pantries that feed the hungry. They feed the elderly, you know. But whatever your passion is, it opens the door for you to meet an eligible person. How about that? Try volunteering. Because think about it. You'll be meet somebody that, you know, that you can relate to. They like volunteering. You like volunteering. You're having a good time. You're relaxed because you really ain't thinking about it. But go cute now, girl. Look nice. Look decent, you know, men. I mean, you know, don't wear no high heels if you're doing the Habitat for Humanity. Put some tennis shoes on. But you can still look cute in your tennis shoes, okay? Okay, how about this one? Hey, go back to school or take a class somewhere. There are a lot of over 50 people over 40 and over people that's going back to school. You can take up a new class. You can expand your knowledge. I mean, how about adult learners love to meet other adult learners? And you know why? And I can give a test to this. Think you're all by yourself, and you're the only one. But then you realize, oh, my goodness, it's people just like me, you know? And so you can, you know, get a partner, especially if you're getting back into it and you want to get into the studying habit and, you know, time management. It's always
you're now listening to Dating and Relationships Real Talk with Dr. Shell on HotAtlantaMix106.com. The beat of Atlanta. You can visit us on the web at ScreenWorksEntertainment.com.
Period and gems, okay? And shout out, I don't get nothing from Barnes & Noble either, but I'm telling you, they have like little coffee parts in there. A lot of people, that's what you like to read. You're an author, or you just like to, you know, go in there. You can buy your books from there. You can sit down and read a magazine for free, okay? You can have some great conversations with the people sitting in there. If you got your computer, you got free Wi-Fi. And I'm telling you, someone always want to talk to you and tell you about the regulars, especially at the coffee shop. They know everybody. You just got to go a few times. You're going to see some of the same ones. You'll know that's a regular. And you'll sit on down, you know. You said, what kind of coffee? You're like, do you drink tea? You know, oh, I like your dress. Whatever, they gonna start a conversation. Do you live around here? Especially if it's a neighborhood, a little spot, you know, especially if you want to, you know about people and be comfortable about people that you meet in your neighborhood. Don't sleep on the coffee shop, Barnes & Noble, or any type of library type place, okay? So these are just a few tips to empower you in dating after 50. You can try a few of them. I try them all. If you try any of them, let me know. Go to my website at MichelleARoberts.com. Go to the contact section and let me know. Were these helpful for you? Michelle, I tried this and it blew up in my face. Boom. Or it really helped me and I was really cool about it. How about that? Don't forget to follow me, guys, on social media. Michelle A. Roberts. .com is my website. Facebook is Michelle A. Roberts, INC. Tweet me at MA Roberts, INC. Don't forget the show airs every Saturday and Sunday from 7 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on HotAtlantaMix106.com. Now let's get on into this letter. Anyway, dear Dr. Shell, did I do something wrong? I was just being truthful. Well, here we go. It says, I've known my friend for about 3 years. We were friends with benefits, but she called it off after only a few months. Well, months later, I called her. We got to talking, and she explained why she called it off. They didn't go into a lot of details, but she said she wanted to be more than the friends with benefits. I asked her out, but then I stood her up because it felt weird that we were just going to be, you know, going out on dates after, you know, being friends with benefits. It was wrong, so I did apologize. She asked if I still wanted to go out, and I declined. We still stayed friends and slept with each other on and off. Mm-hmm. All right. So somebody giving a mixed signal. But anyway, let me go on. This one particular time, I was accompanying her because one of her good friends passed away. One thing led to another, and we had sex. Okay? The condom broke, and she was not on birth control. It was 5 o'clock in the morning, and I almost lost it. I took her to get the morning after pill, but my card didn't work, and she didn't have any money. I got very frustrated. I mentioned to her that I wasn't ready for children, and I didn't want any. I told her she wasn't ready either, since she has a great career. She was quiet the entire time back. She said to me, I'll find a way to get the morning after pill, and left my house immediately. I also told her that it wasn't that I didn't want kids with her. I just don't want any kids. She said she didn't take it personally, and she was fine. F-I-N-E. Mm-hmm. Whatever a woman tell you, she's fine. You in trouble. She hasn't texted me since. I think she's upset. Was what I said bad? I really do like her, and I didn't mean to hurt her feelings. Did I say something wrong? I was just being truthful. Well, did you say something wrong? You was just being truthful. You didn't say something wrong, but it was probably the way you said it to her, okay? She's already sensitive because although she said she wanted to be more than friends with benefits, y'all still been kicking it like friends with benefits, okay? Then you said you were very frustrated when, you know, you freaked out about the condom breaking. And, you know, I can imagine somebody taking me in the middle early morning to go get this pill. Then you, your car don't work and you don't have the money. Then she don't have the money. And you start telling, ranting at her, because that's what it sounds like. You just start fussing, saying you don't want kids, and it wasn't that you didn't want it with her. It probably was, you know, when things like that happen, the moment is spoiled. And then for you to kind of be upset, you know, like it was her fault when y'all are both consenting adults, obviously, I'm sure that it hurt her feelings. It basically hurt her feelings, number one, because the way it sounded to me, I'm just perceiving this, oh, that you said it in a harsh manner. But when she told you she was fine, F-I-N, and whenever a woman tell you she's fine, she's not, okay? She just probably did not want to get into it with you since she hasn't texted you and you hadn't talked to her. It's obvious that she's upset. What I would suggest is if you really do like her, that number one, you need to apologize for what you said. Tell her that you didn't mean to hurt her feelings, you know. Ask her to forgive you for what you said. And can you guys talk about it? Maybe some time has gone, you know, forward. Also, if you really like her and you do not want to be her girl, stop having sex with this woman. Because women, you know, it's a heart thing with us. Normally, if we give our body to a man, our heart is in it. It's not that, you know, and y'all been doing this over 3 years. This is a long time for both of you guys to stop playing, you know, the friends with benefits and just be friends if you can. I don't know, you know, how bad it was, you know what I'm saying, but you're saying that you hadn't heard from her, she hadn't texted you, and she seems like she's upset. She's very upset, okay? Now, did you say something wrong? You were just being truthful? No, but probably the way you said it to her, and then in the heat of the moment, it's all types of emotions going on. Y'all don't rush out, you know, to the store and all this kind of thing. It probably just wasn't a great situation. I would suggest again, give her a call, apologize, send some flowers, send a card. Maybe y'all may not be friends anymore. And if that's so, just talk it up to that it is what it is, you know, but I hope that you guys can mend the situation. All right, we're going to wrap it up for today. This has been a great show. Next week, we'll touch on a few more conversation starters because I did miss some stuff like, you know, what's the most annoying habit someone can ever have. You know, I got a few of those. You know, goals and wishes, just different things you guys can talk about. But remember, please listen in to the show every Saturday and Sunday from 7 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. HotAtlantaMix106.com. Follow me on social media, Michelle A. Roberts, INC. Go to my website, MichelleARoberts.com. Tweet me at M.A. Roberts, INC. This has been another great show. Thank you guys for listening, and I will see you guys next week. Bye-bye.